In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Amen.
As we gather here this day, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us gather together as God's people, as we gather together at this Requiem Mass for Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. We're very much aware of the events that will be taking place in London today, and we keep Her Majesty and her family in our prayers at this time. We pray for our nation, that in the midst of these days, it may come together in solidarity with the poor, with the outcast and the weak. Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give comfort to those who mourn. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of God. Lord, have
mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son, Jesus, died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant, Queen Elizabeth II, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared now, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city and the new Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, as beautiful as a bride all dressed for her husband. Then I heard a loud voice call from the throne, "You see this city? Here God lives among men. He will make his home among them. They shall be his people. And he will be their God. His name is God with them. He will wipe away all tears from their eyes. There will be no more death, and no more mourning or sadness. The world of the past has gone. Then the one sitting on the throne spoke, "Now I am making the whole of creation new." He said, "I will give water from the well of life free to anybody who is thirsty. It is the rightful inheritance of the one who proves victorious, and I will be his God and he a son to me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I rejoice when I heard them say, "Let us go to God's house."
I rejoice when I heard them say, "Let us go to God's house."
I rejoice when I heard them say, "Let us go to God's house." And now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem.
I rejoice when I heard them say, "Let us go to God's house."
Jerusalem is built as a city, strongly compact. It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord.
I rejoice when I heard them say, "Let us go to God's house."
For Israel's law it is, there to praise the Lord's name, there to set the thrones of judgment of the house of David.
I rejoice when I heard them say, "Let us go to God's house."
For the peace of Jerusalem, pray. Peace be to your homes. May peace reign in your walls. In your palaces, peace.
I rejoice when I heard you say, let us go to God's house.
For love of my brethren and friends, I say, peace upon you. For love of the house of the Lord, I will ask for your good.
I rejoice when I heard you say, let us go to God's house.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Happy are those who die in the Lord. Now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them.
Alleluia.
The Lord be
with you. And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. I tell you something, unless a wheat grain falls on the ground and dies, it remains only a single grain. But if it dies, it yields a rich harvest. Anyone who loves his life loses it. Anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Set off on a boat to sail across the sea again. A very beautiful day, a very calm and still day for that sometimes very turbulent place. When we reached the middle of the lake, the captain of the boat stopped the engines, and there was a brilliant peace that descended upon us as we were in the middle of that most beautiful lake. That peace, though, was disturbed, interrupted, is maybe not the best word to use, when I heard the tannoy of the ship begin to crackle, and from the midst of that tannoy, the national anthem began. And the pilgrims all began to sing, God Save the Queen. It was one of the most bizarre singing of the national anthem I've ever done. And right at the end of it, when peace descended once again upon the pilgrims, I would say at the top of my voice, God bless you, Your Majesty, which brought a certain amount of humour to the boat. I was reflecting a week ago last Thursday, when I was in Lourdes, when we got news that the Queen had sadly passed away in Balmoral Castle. I was reflecting that by the time I was born, she had been Queen already for 18 years. And we know that she has lived a long life of dedicated service to our nation, to the Commonwealth, and indeed to the world. Many people have their differing thoughts upon the monarchy and what it stands for. But for me, I reflect always on her dedication and service. For the 70 years that she was Queen, for the years prior to that, where she served her father as he took his role in the monarchy of our nation. And we always ought to remember that she wasn't ever expected to be queen. It was only because of the abdication of her uncle that happened. She was also a great person of faith. I think that came across so many times and in so many ways. And we know that her faith was important to her, not just in her role as monarch, but especially in her role as a mother, as a grandmother, as an aunt, as a person who loved family, as a person who loved nature. Faith was at her heart. And I remember listening last week to the words of one of the bishops of the Church of England, who Sandrine. And he recognised that she did not just pray out of obligation, but she prayed out of a deep sense of faith. And he knew that she, then that she was indeed a true person of faith. The events in London today will be full of pomp and full of ceremony, rightfully so. But it will also be an experience of mourning for her family. And in the midst of these days, we keep them in our prayers. And as I mentioned at the beginning of Mass, we also pray for our nation, that it may draw together in solidarity with the poor, the outcast and the sick. And especially in these times where people we know will find life difficult, that we will draw together to ensure the support is given to those. In our Gospel today, we hear about a man who serves the Lord. He must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will be there. We thank God for the service that Queen Elizabeth II has given to our nation, Commonwealth and Lord. We pray for her in death, that she may receive the glory of eternal life. Eternal rest grants unto her, Lord. So let us gather together in prayer for the Creed, and indeed for all those who have died, and all those who mourn. For Queen Elizabeth II, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our sister, that she who served the Church in the midst of her life may be given also a place in the liturgy of heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us in the midst of our lives, that they may have the reward of their good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. We pray also today for Agnes and Joe Sherman, whose anniversaries occur at this time. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Queen Elizabeth II, that they may be consoled this day and grieved by the Lord, who wept at the death of his own friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us ask for the prayers of Mary, to guide us and support us always in our vocations of life, as we pray together.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
God, who is our shelter and strength, you listen in love to the prayers of your people. Hear now these prayers we offer for our departed sister. Cleanse her and all the faith of the departed when he falls on sin, and grant them the fullness of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through the goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given into human hands and made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual
drink.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the Lord's soul is rich.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Elizabeth, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to earth. By your will we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin. So that the earth from which we came may also bring forth the hope of the resurrection. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we proclaim your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of us, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed, Holy O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks. found us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember your servant Elizabeth, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Agnes and Yoshenri, whose anniversary occurs at this time, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord. Bless us. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body as food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, we may always have the hope of eternal life in Christ. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For the happy repose of Her Majesty the Queen. Almighty God, you are the author and sustainer of all human life.
Grant our intercessions to Elizabeth, our Queen, to whom you granted a long and happy reign as one of these times. May you be forgiven her sins and rewarded with that eternal life. Promise us all those who are born again in the waters of baptism and the power of the Spirit. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Eternal rest and presence of your Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon you. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May your soul, the souls of all faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. Turn over for prayer for the world. Almighty God, source of all consolation, we pray for